Hello, and welcome to a Social Security Minute with AARP North Dakota and the Social Security Administration. Josh Yaskvig, State Director for AARP in North Dakota. With me today, again, as always, is Patty Hoffman, who is the Public Affairs Specialist for North Dakota, South Dakota, and Western Minnesota. Patty, good to see you as always.
Good to see you. Thanks again for having me.
We love doing this. And Patty, lately we've been hearing questions about spousal benefits. And before we get into it, I know there's a difference between married spousal benefits and divorced spousal benefits. So for today, let's just focus on married spousal benefits and we'll come back and do another one on divorced spousal benefits. Make sense to you?
Sounds great.
All right. So talk to me about eligibility requirements to get spousal benefits as somebody who is married.
Okay, so there is an age requirement, so you have to be at least age 62. If you are caring for a child that's under age 16 or you have a disabled child, then you can draw at any age. And then the other key thing is that your spouse has to be currently drawing Social Security in order for you to qualify.
So that's how you get eligible. And then you just mentioned a key thing about qualifying. So now talk to me if you meet those eligibility requirements as a married spouse, how do you then qualify for that spousal benefit?
All right, so if you're currently married and you have not worked and paid into Social Security, or maybe you've worked a little bit and paid into Social Security, but you don't have enough credits to qualify. Or the third thing is, and this is key, is that if half of your spouse's benefit at their full retirement age is higher than your own benefit at your full retirement age, then you may qualify for spousal benefits.
So, how much can you receive from your spousal benefit then?
Okay, you can receive up to 50% of their benefit at your full retirement age. If you start drawing your benefits when you're under your full retirement age and you start drawing it early, then you take a permanent reduction in your benefit, just like you would for retirement benefits.
So, Patty, then the other thing I know you've mentioned before in past presentations and things is, when you talk about drawing up to half of your spouse's, you always pay on your account first, correct? So can you explain that briefly?
Absolutely, absolutely. So if I was going to draw spousal benefits from my spouse, let's say for instance his benefit is $2,000 at his full retirement age, I would be eligible for up to half. But like you said, Social Security always pays on your benefit first. So if I'm eligible for 800 on my own record, Social Security would pay that first. I then would be eligible for an additional $200 as a spouse for a total of $1,000.
Excellent. Appreciate that additional clarification. Patty, as always, good to hear from you and good to talk to you about spousal benefits. We'll do another one for those of you that have questions about divorce spousal benefits. That's a little bit different. So stay tuned and pay attention for that one. This has been another Social Security Minute with AARP North Dakota and the Social Security Administration.